Riding the wave of momentum from their non-conference success, the Aggies began their fourth journey through the Southeastern Conference. Texas A&M was undefeated so far through league play, but their first major test awaited them when Ben Simmons and the LSU Tigers came to College Station. The Aggies were on an 8-game win streak. The Tigers were a media darling. It was the recipe for a record-breaking night inside Reed Arena. So much so, it would go down as the largest attendance in school history. 13,888 were the most fans since 2010 versus Texas. Only fitting on the night that the Aggs were to put on a show. A tight contest for a majority of the game until the end. A&M became just too much for the Bayou Bengals to handle.
See why this team is tops in assists as they are feeding Jalen Jones right now. Oh man, hard to stop that. And the crowd's getting into it right now. Trying to come up with a steal. Fans are going crazy. The pass is down to Jones.
At the end of this special night, it's Aggies 71, Tigers 57. The Aggies were back home inside the friendly confines of Reed Arena, which has become quite the home court advantage. Texas A&M is unbeaten at home this season. Iowa State was coming in as the highest-ranked foe to play inside the venue. Saturday's matchup was a part of the Big 12 SEC Challenge. The Aggs would need to put together one of their best performances to knock off their marquee opponent. This game would exemplify what makes college basketball so great. Both teams came out swinging in the first half. Daniel House would help get the 12th man going with a few highlight finishes with some help from Alex Caruso and Anthony Collins.
Nice move on the finish from Daniel House, senior big-time scorer for the Aggies. Caruso steals it right back. Nice bounce pass. House, another one.
Here's an alley-oop. Got it inside to Daniel House. Two-handed slam. He's the man.
At the end of one, both teams would be at a gridlock, 30-30, with neither team really pulling much momentum. The second half would come down to which team would last energy-wise and who could execute down the stretch. This is where A&M had the upper hand.
Make that shot. Yeah, the big man makes it. Trocho Morello's that same spot.
Hoag, let's rip with a three. Got it! 48-44. Hoag with a three, about two steps off the top of the key.
Huge three-pointers from DJ Hoag and Tony Trocha Morelos would see the Aggies gain the advantage. But Iowa State just wouldn't go away. After a few clutch three-pointers and a couple of scoring droughts for A&M, the Cyclones would have a two-point lead with right around 4 minutes left. Enter Daniel House. From this point in the game, the senior guard would go on to score 12 of A&M's next 16 points.
House is going inside. Here's a layup. Goes for him. It's now 61-58. House from the left side drove in. Got by two defenders. Laid it in 51-58.
Here's House down the lane.
Did he get a foul? Yes. He gets an and one. That just made it 67-60 with 55.9 seconds. Goodness gracious, that was just ugly. Hide the kids, put them under the bed.
Grown man dunk right there.
13 seconds, here goes House. House with a slam. Exclamation point.
In the end, A&M's experience and depth was too much for the Cyclones. It's Aggies 72, Iowa State 62 the final.
Three. One, two, three. 300!
It was the first time in school history the basketball edition of the popular ESPN series College Game Day visited the A&M campus. The hour-long show was set inside Reed Arena and would help set the stage for the main event that evening. Kentucky came into Aggieland as the hottest team in the conference, if not the entire country. The Wildcats had posted four straight double-digit wins over SEC foes. This would be a true test to the quality and fight of this Aggie club. As the game got underway, you just got the feeling this was destined to be a heavyweight bout. Texas A&M would make a run and take a lead, but Kentucky had answers. The Wildcats hit some big shots and took an advantage, but the Aggies came up with their own responses. That's what made this one great. A&M relied on their three-point shooting early. In fact, their first five field goals were all from beyond the arc, courtesy of Jalen Jones and DJ Hoag.
Collins goes to Jones. Let's go with a three. Got it! The Aggies have a 3-2 lead. Collins races to the other end. Goes to Jones. He lets fly with a three. Got it! Wow. 6-4. It's Texas A&M.
Caruso from the corner can't make the three. And the weak side rebound to Gilder. Hoag, a deep one. Got it!
Center Tyler Davis was a focal point. UK did not possess the front court size to handle the freshman. He would be a load and a weight the Wildcats couldn't shed. After 20 minutes, Kentucky took a one-point lead into the break. Second half, the Aggies go on the largest run of the game and took an eight-point lead. However, right on cue, back come the Wildcats. Their guard duo of Tyler Ulis and Jamal Murray, a big part of Kentucky scoring down the stretch. Fast forward, 20 seconds left in the game. After a missed free throw from Kentucky kept the score tied, the Aggies had a chance to win it in regulation. Daniel House would get off a shot, however, it fell short. Keep the curtain open and the lights on. This performance needs an encore. Five more minutes overtime for the second straight year between these two. 9 seconds left in the extra frame. Aggies down one. Anthony Collins drives into the lane. His layup falls short. Isaac Humphrey gets the board. Quickly, the Aggs foul. However, through Humphrey's celebration, he spikes the ball onto the floor, which by rule is a technical foul. The Aggies get two free throws.
First one is a make, ties the game at 76, 9.4 seconds.
I'm always amazed by guys who can do that. Don't take a dribble, just pick it up and shoot it.
Next one, made that one. Aggies take the lead, 77, 76.
Scal Labissiere, who checked in for Humphreys, would take the free throws for Kentucky for the earlier foul. He would make the front end but missed the second shot. Tie game, Aggies ball, 4 seconds. Another chance to win it. After a couple of timeouts, the anxiety in the arena was palpable. A real opportunity was coming, a chance to rejuvenate a season and to topple a true basketball power.
On the baseline, House, 2 seconds to go, goes inside, put back, good! Davis hit a put back, and A&M won it!
How about that?
There's the official word, A&M knocks off Kentucky to tighten things up in the SEC.
Texas A&M had played its way back into net-cutting contention on the last day of the regular season. A historic opportunity stood in front of them. Championship Saturday was finally here. The Vandy Commodores were riding in on a wave of momentum themselves. Winners of four straight, they'd present a tough matchup for the Aggies. On Senior Day, the group playing their last game inside Reed were hoping to hang a banner there upon their exit. Daniel House and Anthony Collins got the offense going.
Great defense there by House.
House in transition and one. Good defense by the Commodores again.
Tough shot.
Yeah, that was even better offense. Collins from downtown knocks down the three.
defensive intensity was key to A&M's success. They forced Vanderbilt into turnovers and several tough shots. Vandy was having a hard time getting into the game.
Davis posting up on the block, working against Cornette. Tough move by the freshman, he got it to go. Hove got it.
At the break, A&M had worked its way into a 7-point lead, 39-32. One more half to a conference title. The Aggies were not going to be denied. Texas A&M came back out on a mission.
Gilder with a nice feed inside. Davis with the bucket. Gilder with the three, yes. Another talented freshman.
The Aggies up the lead all the way to 20 points in the second half. It would be too much for Vanderbilt to overcome.
Hogg on the show and go. Hogg with the dive, Davis. That's the future for Texas A&M. Caruso, Hogg. This thing has blown open. Jones and House and Caruso, the seniors, lead the way as the Aggies win it by 9.
Texas A&M had done it. They'd built themselves into the class of the conference. And for these seniors, it's quite the ride they're on to close their careers.
All the adversity, all the hard work that we put in, I'm just glad I can celebrate the championship with my team.
I couldn't have planned it any better for 4 years to finish senior day at Reed Arena like this. This is just, it's amazing.
Champions, all right? The definition of a champion is a warrior or a fighter who is superior at his work, okay? We have demonstrated that in the regular season. This is postseason. Every game we play from here on out is a championship game, all right? We got 9 left. Every game's important. Let's go get it. Starts right here. Starts right here. So, together on three. 1, 2, 3.
Together.
The first game in a tournament setting is the hardest to win, and Florida was ready for the fight. The first half was a back-and-forth affair.
Chioza's triple-teamed and throws it away, and Caruso's wide open coast-to-coast, and he'll slam it home. Casey Hill throws one up and in. Oh, boy. You can't leave him alone on the baseline.
A&M led by 2 at the break, 34-32. Midway through the second stanza, the score was even at 53. A&M would go on a 6-0 run, resulting in a Florida timeout. But the Gators would regroup. With just under 3 minutes to go, we have another tie.
7 on the shot clock as we approach a minute. House outside, got a 3!
A&M would ice this one from the charity stripe. The Aggies survive and advance. The final score, A&M 72, Florida 66. On Saturday, A&M would face yet another tough opponent, the LSU Tigers. A&M and LSU split a pair of regular season games, each winning on their respective home courts. This time around, the story was different. Facing a Bayou Bengal squad with NCAA tournament hopes on the line, the Aggies were flat out dominant.
Went back here to Morales, pivots. Now he's going to shoot. Here it goes. Did he make it? He did. He just nailed a 3 to tie the game. Driving inside, tries a layup. That's blocked. The Aggies got it. Gilder goes to the other end. Layup. Good Gilder. Boy, took it all the way. He went from one baseline to the other baseline, made the layup. Long pass to the other end goes down to Jones from House. House the assist. Jones the slam. I mean, he threw that one down. Go to the corner to Admon. Admon will put his man in the air. Line drives a 3. Got that! Oh, wow. That was desperation 3, and he hit it. Admon Gilder. And that'll put us at halftime up 35-13.
A&M would outscore LSU 32-5 over the 15 minutes leading into the break. The second half brought more of the same.
Here's a slam. That's an alley-oop and an assist to Collins and an alley-oop slam by House. House goes in, hands it off to Morales, who then turned and gave it to Miller on the baseline. Morales gets an assist. Miller gets a slam. I mean, that was a throwdown, and everybody's getting into the act, and LSU's seen enough.
A Kyle Dobbins free throw with 3 minutes left put the Aggies up by 40. A&M ends LSU's season. 71-38 was the final. A&M's bench was fantastic, outscoring LSU's reserves 42-10. Texas A&M limited the Tigers to just 38 points, the fewest scored by a team from the ACC, Big 12, Big East, Big 10, Pac-12, or SEC this season. Moving on to Sunday, and what an atmosphere it was inside Bridgestone Arena. Over 19,000 fans were in attendance for the showdown between Texas A&M and the Kentucky Wildcats. This was the sixth tournament title game appearance in A&M's history, but the first since 1994. After edging UK in overtime last month in College Station, it was Big Blue Nation that made their voices heard in Nashville. A raucous Wildcat crowd was on edge as A&M and Kentucky went toe-to-toe on the hardwood.
Here's an alley-oop. We go inside. That's a slam by Jones, and LaBessiere fouled him, and that's his second, just like that. Went to the opposite side. They try an alley-oop, and they'll come down, and that will be Marcus Lee on a slam. It's 6-3. Far side to Admon. Admon's going to pull back, shoot, and he made it. Admon will make it a 15-all ball game now.
A&M heads to halftime with a 4-point advantage. After the break, the battle continued. Back and forth they went, trading body shots. This high-level game was shaping up to be an instant classic. Down two with under a minute to go. A&M needed a big shot to stay alive.
House frees up. Briscoe's chasing him, shoots a three. Got it, just tied the game at 75. A minute 50 to go.
A&M would need one more stop to force OT.
Euless looking at it. Euless 3 seconds working here on Caruso. Fadeaway is no good. The buzzer sounds, and we're going OT.
In overtime, Kentucky found their range, hitting on three crucial three-point attempts, the last by Jamal Murray. It put the Wildcats up by 6 with only 18 seconds remaining. A&M could not recover. In a battle of the SEC's finest, the Wildcats outlast the Aggies, 82-77. The disappointment would soon fade as later that evening the team would gather together in their hotel as the NCAA tournament field was announced.
And then to wrap things up in the West region, the third seed in the West, the Aggies of Texas A&M. Our second seed out of the ninth is the Southeastern Conference. The Aggies won their first regular season conference title.
Texas A&M was awarded with the number 3 seed in the West regional, a tie for the highest seeding in school history.
Yeah, boys. Yeah, boys.
Every sprint you ran, every weight you lifted, every time you came to the gym at midnight by yourself to shoot, okay? It got you ready. You shouldn't be nervous like all the work's gonna be for nothing. All it made you is prepared. You're prepared for this moment. You're the better team. Shouldn't be nervous. Go out there, have fun. Let's start.
Get it, baby. Good.
Win on three. 1, 2, 3, baby.
The Aggies were in Oklahoma City for rounds 1 and 2 at Chesapeake Energy Arena. First round, Friday night versus Green Bay, seeded 14th out of the Horizon League. A&M had some early stumbles, but ended up running away from the Phoenix and into the second round.
As Gilder gets the dunk.
The seas just parted.
The Aggs were down 22-14 right out of the gates, but outscored Green Bay the rest of the first half 27-11. Second half, no contest. A&M wins that stanza by 19. The Aggies got scoring from everywhere. Danuel House was the leader. He went for 20.
House for three. Danuel House deep in the shot clock.
Tony Trocheamorelos was quality in this one. 15 points, 6 rebounds.
Caruso drops it off. Trocheamorelos gets it done. Aggies on top. Timeout Green Bay.
The final in the first round. Texas A&M 92. Green Bay 65.
Dobbins!
Yeah!
Good job of settling down and playing like we're capable of playing. All right, did a really good job moving the ball in the second half, extra pass, and attacking the rim. Did a good job of attacking the rim. And defensively, we shut them down. The zone gave them problems. We were big, we were active. It's a big deal. So together, let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Together!
Texas A&M entered the night searching for a fourth trip to the Sweet 16, a season to remember already. Little did we know, a lasting memory was on the way. UNI was planning a Cinderella run after they had upset 6-seed Texas with a buzzer beater from half court in the first round. A tall order had been placed before the Aggies.
Hey, listen, guys always hear that you play for the name on the front of your jersey, and that's right. There's no doubt about it, that's who you play for. But there's a reason on the back of your jersey that has your last name. Okay, because you represent something else besides yourself with the name on the back. The one on the front, State University and these teammates and these brothers you're playing for. The one on the back, that's your family. It's your mom, dad, your pops, your grand, whoever. Somebody puts you out here. Somebody cares about you. Somebody you're living up to what they started you on the path for. Okay, so don't forget that. This is A&M. This is your family. Let's go get this done, baby.
As the game got underway, it was becoming evident the Aggs were off, and UNI was riding their wave of luck.
Ah! I think it's, Cook's an advantage lighter, but he can beat him down the floor, which he did that time. Good run out.
Jesperson. First made three of the game for the hero from Friday, Paul Jesperson. Morgan off the look from Carlson.
House falling asleep that time. What a great back cut from the weak side and pass.
At the break, it's UNI by 10. The second half was largely more of the same. A&M would make runs to get closer, but Northern Iowa would go on another spurt to extend their lead. It was looking like A&M's season was coming to a close. People began to make their way for the exits, a mistake they may regret for a long time. Then the moment came. Down 12, 40 seconds to go. What the Aggies were about to try to do couldn't be done.
And it's a tough place to take the ball out of bounds. You have no timeouts left. Trocheamorelos on the ball.
Aggies get it back. Looking for a miracle. House lays it in.
And can run the baseline, so that's an advantage.
No timeouts either side. Jesperson throws it in. Jones dunks it down. And can the Aggies pull off a miracle in Oklahoma City?
Whole time to just attack the basket, score two.
House tries the three and drills it. Danuel House has pulled the Aggies within three. Caruso, still a two-possession game. Caruso, finger roll count and a foul with 11.8. Washington trapped in the corner. No timeouts for the Panthers. So Washington throws it into the hands of the Aggies. Gilder lays it in. Tie game 71 with 1.9 seconds left. Jesperson into the hands of Washburn. The three-quarter court heave from Washburn. And we go to overtime. Tied at 71. The Aggies down 11 with just over a minute to go. Storm back. OT in OKC.
The Aggies accomplished the impossible. Their season was not over, because to overtime we go. Neither team wanted to give this game away, another OT would decide who would continue dancing to the Sweet 16.
This is the three. Jones, step back. He went and got it. House has it. Less than a minute to go with double OT. House takes it and makes it again. Daniel House has led the shocking comeback for Texas A&M. Morgan's going to take the three. Air ball out of bounds. 3 seconds left. Aggie basketball.
And the Aggie fans are going crazy. They never thought this was even possible with 44 seconds to go.
The Aggie season was over with 44 seconds left in regulation. And now they're on to the Sweet 16 in Anaheim.
I mean, you can't. We play hard. Me and my brothers just played so hard. Like, we didn't want the season to end, so we laid it all on the floor for one another, and we came up victorious.
Still in disbelief, honestly. Down like 12 with 40-something seconds left. I mean, that's crazy that we came back. Most teams would quit, maybe stop all like the fouling and stuff and give up, because I mean, it was like something you just don't see, but it's March Madness for you. It's crazy.
It's joy, happiness, man, just praise to God, man. The whole time I'm on the bench just saying, man, I trust you, Lord. You know, whatever teaching you have to give us from this, you know, whatever happens, whatever the outcome is, you know, my heart is ready for it. And I just kept saying that over and over again. And these guys on the court, man, just believe. Like it's on the board over there, just believe. They just played their asses off, man. Every possession, one possession at a time, man.
We seen they was tired, we seen they was wearing down, so we just wanted to stay the course and keep pressing, and that was our only hope. Keep pressing, and maybe things happen, and they did, and we're victorious.
Team on three, 1, 2, 3!
Team!
Texas A&M reached its fourth Sweet 16 in school history. Once getting to that round, Oklahoma would be too much. In Anaheim for the West Regional, the Aggies' run would come to an end.
Proud of how hard we fought all year, what it took to get to this point. Obviously, the outcome's not what we wanted, but just really proud and happy for my teammates for sticking with it the whole year.
Tough way to lose. I like that. I think me, the seniors, and the rest of this team put all we had into it, and you know, it's a really emotional moment right now because the season's over with, and you know, I'll probably, you know, keep in contact with some of these guys for the rest of my life, and just a sad moment right now. We didn't go out like we wanted to, and it just happens like that sometimes.
Texas A&M could hold their heads high. The season that began thousands of miles away in Europe ended with a championship for the school, the first time since the 1980s. Quite a way for this team and its senior class to go out. Here's to the 2015-2016 Texas A&M Aggies and the lasting memories they provided.